The question says, a ball of mass m is attached to one end of a string of length l. This is kept in horizontal position and released from rest. At what angle from vertical will the tension in the string be equal to the weight in magnitude? So I can say this is the vertical position and this is the horizontal position from where we are supposed to start. So definitely the length is L. It's going to perform a circular motion, you can say a vertical circular motion. I can assume that position they are asking about or they are talking about is say this, which makes an angle theta with the vertical. Now here the weight is mg over here in this direction, which if you extend the string length you get the angle as theta. There is tension acting in the string and the centrifugal force acting on the bob, which is away from it. Now we are supposed to find the angle theta, for which I'm just drawing this line to indicate that though this length is L, this length, what you can see over here, is going to be L cos theta. And from this triangle, this hypotenuse is L. The side adjacent to the triangle or to the hypotenuse is nothing but L cos theta. Now, if I resolve the mg, I get CFF plus mg cos theta in the same direction and mg sin theta as the tangential force. Now from the equation, from the diagram actually, I can say the tension is balancing the centrifugal force plus mg cos theta. And from the question they say tension is mg. So if I substitute this over here, I get mg is equal to CFF, which is mv square by L, plus mg cos theta. If I take mg cos theta on this side, I can take mg common. In the bracket, I will have 1 minus cos theta, which is mv square by L. Definitely, I can cancel m over here, and I get v square as gl bracket 1 minus cos theta. I consider this as equation number 1. Now if I apply law of conservation of energy, I can say the total energy at this point A and the total energy at this point B must be same. So using law of conservation of energy, the potential energy at A is potential energy at B plus potential energy, kinetic energy at B. The at A, the potential energy is mgh, where h is height L itself. So mgl. At B, the height is this, the A length, which you can see over here, which is the total length L minus L cos theta. So I can say mgh as the potential energy and the kinetic energy as half mv square. Now definitely we can cancel this m throughout and we can substitute LH as L minus L cos theta, which is equal to, which plus is v square by 2. Now if I open the bracket, I get GL is equal to GL minus GL cos theta plus v square by 2. GL will get cancelled and I take this on the other side, gives me GL cos theta is equal to V square by 2. Therefore V square is 2GL cos theta. Now I can consider this as equation 2. As you can see both the equations, the left hand side is same, so I can equate the right hand side, which gives me from 1 and 2 GL bracket 1 minus cos theta is equal to 2GL bracket cos theta. the GL gets cancelled. Now 1 minus cos theta is 2 cos theta. That gives me 1 as 3 cos theta. Therefore, cos theta is 1 by 3. So theta is cos inverse of 1 by 3, which is the final answer.